places I remember all my life. Though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain. All these places have their moments. With lovers and friends, I still can recall.
John, I love you. I miss you. Did you forget who I am? I'm your mother.
Where the water meets the sky, the thought of it makes me smile. You are my tomorrow. I'll see you again. Oh, this is not where it ends. I'm okay. You with me, oh, till I see. this is not where it ends. I will carry you with me. Yeah, yeah. I will see you again. Oh, this is not where it ends. I will carry you with me. Oh, till I see you again.
Early on one winter's morning, I took the road to Island Bridge. 'Twas there I spied a fair young maiden walking by a greenwood hedge. Where are you going, my lovely maiden, on this cold and winter's day? She said, my friend, I walk with angels to guide the stranger on his way. Gentle maiden, how I love you, and my heart it breaks in two. All the stars up in the heavens could never shine bright as you. But I am just a lonely traveler, lost within a stranger's land, where no angels walk beside me, where there's none take my hand.
In the latter half of the '80s, Pat met a charming, dashing young man with whom she was smitten. As if marrying my father wasn't courageous enough, Pat made another courageous and bold decision. She decided to move her family and start a new life here in the Midwest.
There's Nanny. Hi, Nanny.
In the nearly 30 years since I've known and met Pat, I've learned to understand and appreciate why my dad loved her so dearly. Pat was always respectful to all of us, treated our family as her own, with unbridled kindness, love, and respect. Pat's selflessness manifested itself in a variety of ways. She was always willing to give her time and her resources to help anyone in need. Who amongst us doesn't recognize and or have one of these? Pat was well known for making these blankets for all of us all the time. Thank you.
everything is fine here. This is, I'm putting flowers in my rock garden, and they're really beautiful. Hope everyone is fine. I love you all, and I miss you all. Talk to you later.
Imagine the grief that Patty had to endure in the passing of her daughters, niece, and Cathy. There's comfort in knowing now that they can be reunited, that they are together again. And I'm sure Patty's thinking now happily about that. Now that her suffering is ended, she can enjoy her time with her daughters again.
All the faithful departed, we pray, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, your word, O Lord, is the joy for our lives. Alleluia,
mentioned earlier, Pat had six children whom she loved. Many grandchildren, loved all of them, immeasurably. And I know recently she was able to, given the timing of the events, it was a blessing, able to spend 2 weeks with her lovely daughter, Maureen. Both of them had something very special, given the timing of how it transpired. I'm sure that was something that we're both pleased to have that time together. Pat's love and spirit lives on in all of us. People we know, people we treat, our loved ones, our family, our friends, even strangers, the people we touch. We are all better off for having the opportunity to know Pat. She's touched us all in unique and special ways, and it's our duty to pass that forward so that can hold on to me. Of all the money that ever I spent it in good company. And all the harm that ever I've done, alas, it was to none of me. And all I've done for want of wit, to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass, good night and joy to you.